a joy to have you with us here on this day after Labor Day. We didn't have a video yesterday because of the holiday, but I'm glad you can be back with us today. And I want to encourage all of us to realize that our lives are not about ourselves. They are about the truth that God has given to us as believers and communicating that truth. I've said several times over these last few months that one of the ways to get out of discouragement or out of a sense of just the pressure of all that's happening is to start giving instead of focusing on ourselves. The natural thing is to think through all that's happening and to be burdened about it. And that's even why we're having these times together, because that's just the normal way we respond. But one of the key ways to keep out of that perspective is to have a passionate burden to reach others with the gospel and then to give of ourselves to see them through to genuine victory. God says to us through the Apostle Paul in Colossians chapter 1 that we are to do all that we can to bring people to a place of completion, being perfect in Christ Jesus. And I'm moved by the testimony of the Apostle Paul in Acts chapter 20 when he was with the Ephesian elders for the very last time. He was heading back to Jerusalem. There he would be imprisoned. He knew that problems were facing him. So this was a very emotional time. And in his encouragement to them and his challenge to them, he says something very stunning in chapter 20, verse 27. For I have not shunned to declare unto you all the counsel of God. Now, of course, the Apostle Paul was a leader, and God had gifted him to train these elders to do the work that that God had given to them. But this still is the essence of the Great Commission, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And so we see the passion here of the Apostle Paul, not to hold back anything, but to bring people through to genuine understanding and victory in their lives. And God wants us to do that. Ephesians 4 talks about the fact that the leadership gifts perfect the saints so that the saints can do the work of the ministry, so the saints can edify the body of Christ. And it goes on to talk about understanding truth and walking with Christ and knowing error and to be able to be a functioning part of the body. Well, you find that in verses 12 to 16 of chapter 4 of Ephesians. That's where God wants each of us to live. And I tell you, when you get passionate about seeing people through, your whole paradigm on life changes. Instead of worrying about ourselves, we begin to be very concerned about the lives of those that God has put into our lives. And it's just freeing. It's a glorious thing. It means we've got to keep learning truth. We've got to keep growing. We've got to keep allowing God to mold us through the different circumstances that we're in. Life makes sense. Life becomes vibrant. It's not just a static surviving. It's now an ongoing process so that we can fulfill the call that God has upon our lives. So I want to encourage you today to just say, Lord, I just want to keep growing. I want to see someone all the way through. I want to give of myself. I don't want to live with allowing pressures to dominate at all. Even though they're there, I want to respond properly. And I know, Lord, that it's going to be the giving of myself. If you'll do that, God will do it. He is looking for servants that he can trust, and may today be the beginning of a life of seeing people through to victory.